And so for our Johnsonville County Commissioners, we have Commissioner Shankly, Commissioner Harris, Commissioner Smith, and Commissioner Lodi. They're all sitting up here. I'm Commissioner Grant. I'm the chair. I'm going to read my opening statement. Okay, and this will set it up, and then we'll go from there. Okay, commissioners, remember that we are voting. So we are the ones that we're listening. So welcome to the Johnsonville County Commissioners meeting. Today's hearing is focused on whether or not we're going to ban the use of pesticides in Johnsonville County. As the chair of the county commission, I'm duty bound to remind my fellow commissioners that we represent the county and the people of this county, which includes ourselves, as well as all of our constituents. We should be thinking of what is best for our 6,000 residents and citizens of Johnsonville County, not just our personal agendas. This is a very complex issue. It will impact many sectors of our community. Therefore, it is important that we have an open and honest discussion that considers the economic, social, and environmental impacts of banning the use of pesticides in Johnsonville County. It should be noted that we will not be able to stop food and other products that have been grown or benefited from the use of pesticides outside of this county. This is solely about the use of pesticides within our county limits. Today's commission hearing will allow us to hear from the community. I ask those of you who are presenting their concerns today to be mindful of our time limits and overall rules of open and respectful discussion. Everyone here will have equal time to talk of 2 minutes. I'll have a timer up that you can see and follow with that. There will be also time to ask questions at the end. The commissioners and I will run that and we'll identify you accordingly when it is your time. So I thank you for your patience. At the end of the hearing, the commissioners and I will vote on the issue at hand. Our hope is that the stakeholders present today will have a chance to express their concerns and issues for this important decision. And with that, I would like the commissioners to make their opening statements on their positions. Again, reminding you all have 2 minutes. We'll start with Commissioner Shankly. What's your position, Commissioner Shankly? Are you for or against this ban, and why?
I'm against the ban of pesticides for agricultural purposes because there are several like pros of pesticides. So like they can actually help reduce food waste. So most people think that the only time pesticides are like used is on crops like in the field. But they're actually used in like packaging and even in grocery stores to reduce like insects and rodents getting on them. So like if we don't have pesticides, we're not able to use them in those types of scenarios and possibly be wasting a lot of the food that we do grow. And there's also like a lot of diseases that you could get from like not having pesticides. So like ticks and mosquitoes and stuff spread stuff like malaria and like Lyme's disease, which people actually like still get in America. And if we had pesticides, we would not. Well, if we had pesticides, there'd be less chance of having them because they're only spread by like mosquitoes and just ticks and fleas and stuff. And then just in general, like economic wise, they're pretty, pesticides are practical for farmers because they like increase productivity. So if you use pesticides, there's a less chance you're gonna get like I said, like diseases and weeds and stuff like that that are gonna like reduce the amount that you get out of the land that you have. So a lot of times like farmers will lose a lot of crops to weeds and stuff. So if you have pesticides, they're able to use their land more like economically and stuff. And if they have if they grow everything on the land they have,
All right, thank you, Commissioner. Commissioner Harris, 2 minutes.
So I think I'm gonna against banning pesticides, because I think that like the economic, like it could be economically kind of catastrophic for the area, because areas like the golf course really need insecticides and herbicides to stay looking green and appealing. So having a bad looking golf course could really deter tourists from the area, resulting in economic loss. Also without these chemicals, maintaining the grass at the golf course would be a lot more expensive. We'd have to hire a lot more groundskeepers for weeding, like maintaining the green. Well, like it would involve a lot more time. So basically, maintaining the golf course without pesticides and other chemicals would be very difficult, and the economic consequences would not be good for the county.
Thank you, Commissioner Harris. Commissioner Smith, let's hear from you, please.
So I am for the ban of pesticides because they are bad for your health. I personally have experienced it because I had cancer and my wife died of cancer as well, and I think it is because of the excessive use of pesticides around the area. And not only does it affect people because it's now in the air and in our water, but it especially affects pregnant women with prenatal birth, and the children end up having neurological damage, which is obviously not great. And I think it is important to keep our families and ourselves safe, so we should not be using pesticides, or at least not as much as we do, because they're used at, like, in our homes, at school, or places like that, because to get rid of insects and things like that. And I think we should maybe turn to natural predators other than pesticides.
Okay, thank you, Commissioner Smith. And finally, we'll hear from Commissioner Lodi.
I am for the ban of pesticides, even for health reasons and the cost of health care. And they're found, pesticides found everywhere, in every food we eat, the water we drink. And particularly developing children are vulnerable to pesticides. It has proven that children from 6 to 11 have significantly higher levels of pesticides residues in their body than any other age group. And they've been found to cause irreversible brain damage in infants when they're exposed to insecticide put in the womb. And other issues can range from reproductive and developmental effects, cancer, kidney, liver damage, and endocrine disruption. The World Health Organization estimates that between 1 to 5 million people each year, or no, 1 to 5 million people have acute poisoning and die. And farm workers particularly are vulnerable to this too, just because they're in such close contact with their food. And some of the short-term effects include blindness, coma, and death, as well as long-term effects such as infertility, birth defects, and cancer. So my solution is to reduce the use of chemical pesticides and encourage the use of biopesticides and naturally occurring substances.
All right. Thank you, Commissioner. Now we're going to hear from the stakeholders, people that have come to the hearing. The public now has their chance to express their concerns and their issues that we, the commissioning and governing body, need to hear to make a decision. we're not going to go in any particular order. It's kind of volunteer-based. So if you are interested in going first, I recognize business owner Lila.
I'm actually not a business owner.
Oh, sorry, you're the kayaking, biking, sports and business. I forgot he used to own that hammock store down on Main Street. Sorry, go ahead, Lila. You have 2 minutes.
So, I really like outdoor sports, and pesticides are really bad for pretty much anything you can think of, especially the sports that you plant fields, because they usually use pesticides to like keep them green and nice and whatever, but it, when people apply it on those fields, they are breathing in the pesticides and the pesticides will get all over their skin and their clothes, and it can end in really bad, it can end really badly because there's a lot of different things that pesticides can cause, such as like there's a bunch of illnesses like Parkinson's, asthma, depression, anxiety, ADHD, cancer, and illnesses like leukemia and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. But it's also not so. Another thing is like for fishermen and people who the pesticides that are being used will get into the water and the soil, and so the fish or whatever they're catching becomes contaminated, and then if people are selling those fish that are contaminated with pesticides, then they can ultimately be poisoned as well with the pesticides that travel through all these things.
Thank you. Would you like to speak? Oh, yes, okay. So, president of local chapter, Sierra Club.
So, our mission at the Sierra Club is mostly to protect the environment and make people aware of the harmful effects of exterior substances on the environment. So, one of the main things that I found out is that over 98% of sprayed insecticides, 95% of herbicides do not hit their intended targets, so therefore they're just being released into like the air, soil, and the water, which are getting hit instead of the plants or whatever they're trying to reach. And it's referred to as pesticide drift and is one of the leading causes of water pollution. Furthermore, it harms humans, especially children. Exposure of humans to pesticides can have acute and delayed impact. Thus, various health effects have been observed, from like simple skin or eye irritation to more severe infections like of the nervous system or hormones. And there have been suspicions linked to pesticides of like fatal diseases, including cancer, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, as well as hormone disruption, birth defects, sterility, and neurological effects. And according to the UN, an average of about 200,000 people die from toxic exposure of pesticides each year across the world. And they can have what they coined as catastrophic impacts on human health, as well as the environment. And one good reason why pesticides are especially harmful to children is because their vital organs are just starting to develop, and they breathe a little faster than adults, so therefore they are more likely to have to ingest a larger amount or inhale a larger amount, and then also they're closer to the ground where the pesticides are being sprayed, so they're prone to inhalation there too. Furthermore, it harms animals as their immune systems are weakened by pesticides just as the humans are. And it builds resistance. So just like living organisms, pests are likely to build up resistance to chemicals used in pesticides, and then the more you use, the more they resist it, and you have to keep using more and more. And the last thing was, although it increases food productivity and abundance, it hasn't
really. Thank you. I'm sorry, your time is up. Thank you so much for your presentation. I have to stay on top of the time in order for everybody to have their equal say. Thank you, President Chad. All right. We'll hear from Bella. You represent the Natural Resources Conservation Service, is that correct?
Yep.
Okay, go ahead, begin your time.
Okay, so using pesticides has some long-lasting negative impacts on the environment. Pesticides, when they're sprayed on crops, can then contaminate groundwater, which ultimately leads to the ocean and causes eutrophication. Eutrophication is where nutrients from land enter the ocean, creating flourishing surface while simultaneously creating a dead zone or hypoxia on the ocean floor. So with eutrophication, aquatic life doesn't flourish below the surface. I believe that for those reasons and many others, the environment for the environment, we should not use pesticides. Although food lasts for a shorter amount of time without using pesticides, you do not run the risk of someone getting sick from consuming or mishandling the pesticides along with contaminating water. Information Network states, pesticides are poisonous and unfortunately they can harm more than just the pests at which they are targeted. They are toxic and exposure to pesticides can cause a number of health effects. They are linked to a range of serious illnesses and diseases from respiratory problems to cancer. We need to protect the people in our county. I believe that we should ban pesticides and replace them with naturally occurring ways of keeping pests in check because the risk we run of people getting ill and contaminating our surroundings is not worth the small benefit that pesticides provide.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, the recognizes Homeowners Association President Jane. You have your 2 minutes, go ahead.
Thank you. So, speaking for the community, the positives of pesticides greatly outweigh the negatives. So, for one, pesticides reduce the risk of insect-borne diseases such as malaria and Lyme disease, which are great concerns in our county, especially during the warmer weather when the people, including our children, spend more time outside. I also want to bring up the fact that pesticides are very helpful for homeowners because they get rid of termites and all that harmful things to houses. So on Amazon, pest killers can be bought for just $30, which can prevent termites and other unwanted guests in the house. Without using this method, we are subject to the destruction of our houses, which would cause tremendous economic losses. So according to HomeAdvisor, it can cost up to $2,000 to rid your house of termites, when it could have been prevented for just $30. And even the more expensive extermination still uses chemicals, such as those in pesticides, so there's really no other option for maintaining the quality of our living than using pesticides. And not using pesticides means a lot more labor, which is expensive, and it makes the product more expensive. So it's far more beneficial to buy affordable vegetables, even if pesticides have been used to treat them, because it allows for a healthier diet for our children. And I also want to mention that organic or plant-based pesticides, such as rotenone, is 55 times more toxic than salt and is linked to Parkinson's disease and has caused death, so that's actually not a good alternative for pesticides.
Thank you. Next we'll hear from environmental health worker Vaughn.
So to begin with, I think pesticides do have some positive effect. So it's really effective in killing harmful pests, such as mosquitoes that give human malaria. Pesticides can also directly cause diabetes, cancer, and other tumors over time. If consumed by mistake or inhaled in large amount, especially by farmers and people who live in your farms, pesticide can directly lead to death. 1 million people per year have died because they have consumed food inhaled in the air or their eyes have come into contact with pesticides. Although pesticides can keep food affordable and allows farmers to produce more and less land, pesticides only work for large commercial farms and it discourages smaller farms because it lowers the price of commercially produced food. One can also argue that it makes production more makes farms more productive, but it actually causes the loss of biodiversity in soil, which prevents productivity. Farmers usually use general pesticides, which will not only kill just the pests that they target, but also non-target organisms that are beneficial to plants. Insects are also becoming genetically resistant to pesticides, causing farmers to use more and more pesticides. The process of researching and producing pesticides is also expensive, and this money can be invested in developing other solutions. So with that being said, I think I am for the ban of pesticides.
Thank you. Any other stakeholders who'd like to speak? Okay, Amy from the chair of the Tourism Bureau, you have 2 minutes.
So I'm here for the use of pesticide. Since we're, I'm the chair of the Tourism Bureau, my goal is to represent the best side of the town to the travelers. So we use pesticides to kill fungicide things such as grass, weeds, and termites. In this way, we attract more tourists who can help boost up the economy for our town. So my reasons are the following. Socially, some might say that using pesticides are noxious to human health. However, this is an overrated effect. Nowadays, in the environment, most pesticides undergo photochemical transformation to produce new tablets, which are relatively non-toxic to both human beings and the environment. Economically, by using the pesticides, lots of workers and laborers could be free. They can pursue education and opportunities away from farming, thus improving the quality of life and the living standards. It takes 70 million workers to remove the weeds from crops in the U.S. So with more educated people in town, more business could be developed, such as bookstores, cafes, and shops that advertise the specialty of our town to offer entertainment to the tourists. So thirdly, environmentally speaking, using pesticides can help conserve the environment. They enable farmers to produce more crops per unit area with less tillage, thus reducing deforestation, conserving natural resources, and curbing soil erosion. Pesticides can also, are also critical for the control of invasive species and noxious weeds. Since tillage fractures the soil, it disrupts the soil structure, accelerates surface runoff and soil erosion. We are not only focusing on the economic gain of using pesticides, we can also conserve the soil so that we can improve the environment. In this way, we can demonstrate a perfect town to the tourists. So some were talking about the using natural predators to deal with the pests. That might be a way to invasive species problems. But I think targeted pesticide is the best solution to the problem.
Okay, thank you for your time. Now we'll hear from local business owner Nadia. You may begin your time.
Okay, so I sell pesticides at my hardware store, and so this whole conversation is actually really frightening for me because I make a lot of money off of my pesticides and selling them, and we sell them to local sports fields and golf courses that, like Jonah said, need to stay green. So without these pesticides, not only is our town and our tourist section losing money, but I personally am losing money in my business. And once our town starts, like, that's two things, right? Two companies, like business owners right there, that are losing money. And then our farmers alone will lose money if we start just like cutting it out, because worldwide, and of course, like this, we're talking about our town, but it does affect the rest of the world as well. 26 to 40% of crops are being wasted because of weeds, pests, and disease. And with 925 people around the world going hungry, we really can't afford to waste any food. We need to like use what we can, and that is in a much broader aspect. But if we start doing it here, then it's not gonna. Then if we start eliminating pesticides here, we are just playing a part into the hunger and the waste that is happening. And so I personally believe that we should keep them around because we'll all start losing money, and we think that it only affects like the farmers and a few people, but it actually will end up affecting all of us and our jobs.
Thank you. So we'll hear from retired military Johnny and fly fishing business Johnny.
Yeah.
Go ahead, sir, you have 2 minutes.
So people are exposed to an unknown level of pesticides in their diets. For example, if somebody eats like a fruit like an apple, there may be pesticide residue on it. You're supposed to like wash it off to help protect yourself from that, but some people don't, and we also just don't know like if that actually does anything. But as people have said, like this has a negative effect on the health of human beings when they're exposed to pesticides, and they're widely used on things that are grown. Pretty much all farmers use them, so that can definitely like these chemicals can build up and have a negative effect on people. Specifically, evidence suggests that children are susceptible to effects from exposure, and these effects include neurodevelopmental issues. Pesticides are so widely used that it's pretty easy to be exposed to them. Farmers also continue to use more and more pesticides, which causes weed and insects. pesticides are being used, and between 500 and 1,000 insect and weed species have developed pesticide resistance since 1945. And you know, pesticides can be very toxic to humans, have immediate and chronic health effects. And you know, depends on how much a person is exposed to, but if you're a farmer, greenhouse worker, you're just around pesticides very often, you know, you will likely feel an effect from them, especially the older, cheaper pesticides like Lindane and DDT can remain for years in soil and water.
Thank you for your time, sir. Next we'll hear from Carlos, the director of Farmers Market.
So my main concern about pesticides in America is basically the unfair competition between organic farmers and traditional farmers. The thing is about traditional farmers, you all know that they always practice pesticides and crop rotation and all that stuff, and organic farmers are more smaller and more local. The thing is, as I researched this recently, I saw that in the USDA's farmers market that's located outside Washington, D.C., it states that this place is basically where many farms from like smaller farms would expand or practice any type of farming, basically. And they can bring any type of crop and they can expand it. And however, as I read the regulations, what to bring to this convention center, it's basically agricultural products such as flowers, plants, trees, fruits, vegetables, grain products, honey, eggs, milk, must be from the farmers or growers' own fields. Selling goods from any neighbor's farms only allowed if the market participant and neighboring farms are both members of the same farmer and rancher or fishery cooperative. Basically, I don't see anywhere it says that you don't have to bring pesticides to this convention center. So basically, you can be a traditional farmer and bring your stuff to the convention center and say, oh, hey, I can come expand my farm and say, hey, I can use pesticides, but it doesn't really regulate anybody. However, if you want to regulate somebody that wants to be an organic farmer, it doesn't. Ironically, the USDA doesn't really enforce it. So.
Okay. Thank you. Any other stakeholders that would like to speak? Yes. Dr. Thompson? Dr. Thompson, ornithologist.
Hello, I'm a retired ornithologist and a beekeeper, and I'm for the ban on pesticides because simply the cons outweigh the pros. The first con is it affects human health. Exposure of humans to pesticides can have an acute and delayed impact. Thus, various health effects have been observed, from simple skin or eye irritation to more severe infections to the nervous system or hormones leading to various fatal conditions. The second con of pesticide use is the environmental impact. There is a huge possibility that the pesticides will not reach their intended target most of the time. In fact, it was found that over 98% of sprayed insecticides, while 95% of herbicides do not hit intended targets. For this reason, unintended targets such as air, soil, and water get hit instead. This is referred to as pesticide drift, in which air carries the said pesticides to certain areas that result in contamination. In fact, it has been found that pesticides have been linked to the leading causes of water pollution. It also affects my beloved bees. A 2018 report from the Scientific Risk Assessment Authority confirmed that pesticides have a serious danger to honeybees and wild bees. The opposition may state that pesticides are beneficial but are only able to use economic principles and not the more important social and ecological principles. Because not using pesticides will increase mortality and health, it is crucial that it be banned.
Thank you for your time. Excellent. Now, this time we'll have open discussion of 10 minutes, and then we'll have our vote. I'd like to begin the first question. I'll start the timer. I have a follow-up question for Mr. Myers about the farmers market. I just wanted a point of clarification. So are you saying that organic farmers are able to use pesticides?
Yes.
Okay.
We all believe that organic farmers say that, oh, we don't really use any pesticides in our products, which is kind of false. It states that they use pesticides, but it doesn't really harm anybody in some cases. It only has like 1% the scale of like the EPA, basically saying that, you know, they have pesticides, but it's not really harming anybody. So you can bring organic farms can have pesticides in their
Another question, follow-up question, same avenue around farmers markets. Were you also implying that farmers that come to the farmers market can come out of the county?
Yes.
So therefore, the competition amongst our county farmers might be unfair. Is that what
yes.
I was understanding?
That's it.
Okay. Excellent. Commissioners, you have any other questions? I have another point of clarification. Knowing our region, several of our stakeholders claim that pesticides would reduce malaria. Is there any data that we've ever had malaria in this part of North America?
No, we've had
this
Lyme.
This is a place.
Oh, we've had Lyme.
Isn't this just a place?
I'm sorry, we're talking about malaria.
The point is,
yeah, it's supposed to be like
Andy. And if we have pesticides,
what?
It's supposed to be like Andy.
But you said it could be anywhere. Because we're not.
I thought it was everywhere.
You were like, it's just
in okay.
Canada.
All right. In North America.
There's been no.
Well, Alan, if there ever was malaria, if we had pesticides,
like Florida, there wouldn't be.
Okay, but Lyme is
the case.
Right. Point taken. There are other diseases. Just want to make sure that using alarmist words like malaria, when it is not prevalent in this country except maybe in Houston and the Keys of Florida, is a little bit alarmist for this forum. It's certainly factual that there are other diseases that are carried by mosquitoes, equine encephalitis, West Nile virus, and then there's numerous tick-borne diseases, everything from Lyme disease to the dreaded Lone Star tick, anaphylactic shock to beef. Yes.
Also, with like everybody saying the kind of having contact with pesticides to the skin and breathing it in, there's actually like not a lot of proof of that in more developed countries like the United States. It's more in developing countries where they're applying the pesticide without protective gear, where they're getting sick and dying because they don't have the proper methods of applying it.
So can I clarify that statement? So are you saying, Commissioner, that because of our OSHA rules, which is Occupational Safety and Hazards Association, which requires our workers, like at your golf course, sir, are required to wear breathing apparatus and protective gloves, and et cetera, that are required by the manufacturer of that pesticide or herbicide. Is that correct, sir?
Yes.
If you, with your
yes.
application, I know Sam mentioned this, but
it's a very interesting point to consider is the pesticide drift impacts. Is there any data that supports that claim, Commissioner?
Data
about polluting a waterway. I mean, I've heard some percentages from some of our stakeholders, but nothing specific, a case study maybe, or something. There's a discussion, there's early groundwater claims, nothing specific. There was claims of it can harm pregnant women, can harm bees. Are we seeing those losses in this area?
Well, yes.
Roll with that.
If it's a farming town,
which we are. We're a farming town.
There's pesticides everywhere, and they run off into the water, and they're more in here than other towns, and therefore we are more exposed to pesticides.
Are you saying, Commissioner, that because of our nature of our rural county and the prevalence of farming, that with continued use of pesticides of this nature, we therefore put our community at greater risk each year?
Yes. Especially since pesticides do get stronger because of the pesticide treadmill thing that we talked about earlier.
What if instead of ban pesticides, we allow pesticides, but then like endorse the use of like IPM.
What is IPM, Commissioner?
It's integrated pest management. So it's like they use a combination of like biological, cultural, physical, and chemical controls to like manage plants and stuff. So like you can use like natural enemies. So like other things like what's one of them? Predators, parasites, stuff like that. So
okay.
You can just take advantage of like the environment around you instead of using pesticides. And then there's like ways that you can one of them actually says changing integration practices can reduce pest problems since too much water can increase root disease and weeds. And then like, so they do like everything in their power to control the environment. And then once that doesn't work, they use a selective form of pesticides that don't affect humans or that have less effect on humans.
Interesting. So you're, to clarify, you were saying you would like to amend. You're suggesting that we don't accept the ban.
Yeah, don't ban.
Because it's saying all pesticides, and you're saying we can do something that integrates other options. Is that
while
that,
keeping
is that,
pesticides.
While keeping pesticides.
But making
you,
it like not the first option.
You mentioned cultural controls. What do you mean by that?
Like irrigation and stuff like that.
Sorry?
Irrigation.
How does that control? Relate to pesticides.
Too much water can increase weeds.
Any other comments?
It should also be noted that pesticides are getting healthier and healthier and more environmentally friendly. Obviously, there are a lot of environmental impacts, but they're.
Sorry to interrupt, Commissioner. Can you give me an example instead of a broad generalization?
So, actually,
make us believe it. We have a vote ahead of us in 2 minutes.
I have a chart here from 1999 to 2008 that shows the deaths from pesticides.
Great. Well, you were saying that they were getting healthier.
So,
can you give an example of a pesticide that has gotten healthier? Because we've heard some very serious concerns from commissioners and stakeholders about cancer and other diseases to children. Do you have some evidence that can sway us?
I just have that chart that shows that the deaths have gone down substantially in the early 2000s, but I don't have specific pesticides.
Yes?
Like Roundup Ready, for example, this year is like going through this whole like lawsuit where if you or a family member like has been in contact with Roundup Ready and now has.
Can I just clarify something, Bella? It's not Roundup Ready, that's the type of corn, but Roundup, the chemical glyphosate.
Yeah.
But you're correct,
well,
keep going.
Well, there's like this whole like lawsuit going on that
yes.
people are getting, money back if they have developed cancer because of this pesticide.
I believe there's a lawsuit
yeah.
from a worker
yeah.
who's following OSHA rules. He sued and received millions in compensation from the makers of glyphosate.
Oh, I also read that there are regulations to pesticides, and they change. They are changing more and more every time.
Yeah, the laws are fluid. That is true. Good point. As the time grows to a close, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you for contributing to the discussion. We are now going to have a vote. Commissioners are going to vote. Stakeholders will be able to raise their hands as well. Your vote counts as one. Commissioners count as two, and then personally, you should submit your viewpoint, and et cetera. We can have a further conversation.
So, are we supposed
to
vote
personally right now?
We're voting based on our commissioners.
You're voting on we're going to play act our voting thing. Everybody, remember, politicians. Even though we make fun of politicians for flip flopping, they should. Behave the way where their opinions change in light of the facts.
Can we email
so,
you our...
You're going to email me your personal vote, and then now we're going to do our play acting stuff, how you think your character may vote. You may say maybe they have a heart and change. lists out votes for this ban of all pesticides in Johnsonville County. We're going to ban the pesticides, all of them. Please raise your hand for acknowledgement as I count the votes.
To ban it?
To ban it in completion, every single type of pesticide. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Think about the golf courses, guys.
Think about the
okay, against, hands up for against the ban. I'm against the ban. So it's 2, 4, 6. No, not 6. 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm against the ban because, I don't think it's the right choice. I think we should do something integrated as well. One point I will say for the farmer market stuff is there are such things as organic pesticides. But
so we got to email you our actual vote?
Yeah, email me your personal reflection. Your personal reflection is how would you actually vote and why?
Alan?
A couple sentences. Yes, Bella.
My personal vote, my reflection is in the document with my argument.
That's where I want. That's wonderful. Yes. Great. That's what I want too. Fantastic stuff, everybody.
I do want to send off. Can I make it
longer?
No. Okay. It's fine. You're great, Nadia. It's great. Good stuff. We'll discuss what we learned later.
Where are you going?
Okay, fantastic. Thank you so much. All right.
See you, Alan.
Thanks, Johnny. Good job.
I shared it with you.
Man.
And then I also have my vote down there.
Say what?
I shared it with the doctor.
That's great. That's what I want you to do. We'll discuss this further next class about integrated pest management. Here, I will play.
What?
Will play.
Will play.
Thanks,
Alan.
Yeah. That's fine.
Okay.
That's great.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
Yeah.
Good stuff. Good stuff, huh?